These short videos were filmed during the 2009 annual T-Cubed conference and feature teachers presenting their ideas using TI technology to peers and colleagues.
So I'm very quickly going to set up my time graph by making it go for 10 minutes, so a 600 second experiment. I'm very quickly going to change the window settings so that the minimum, the Y minimum is negative 20 and maximum is 100. Okay, and now, before I press go, you are going to make a prediction for what the temperature will be at the end of the first minute. Okay, now, in your zero, your time zero, we should put the time at what will be in experiment terms time zero, which is 93.93 exactly. So we started the experiment at 93, and you now have a prediction for the temperature at time one. Okay, now obviously you have your prediction column filled in. To the right-hand side, you are going to write on what basis you made your prediction, okay? You are then going to check the people sat next to you to make sure they have done likewise. I think it's very interesting, by the way, that adults are very much less willing to commit themselves to why they might do something because they know that it might come back to bite them. Young people, in the main, do not seem so to be. Okay, so we started at 93 degrees. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 91.4. So that's the actual temperature at the end of the first minute. 91.4. You're now going to enter your prediction for the temperature at the end of the second minute. And naturally, you're getting the idea now, you will write on what basis you are making this prediction. Okay, so it's 90.1 degrees. You don't know what you're doing now. You're putting in your prediction for the end of the next minute, and you are perhaps updating or perhaps repeating, I don't know, the basis on which you made your prediction. It works perfectly well with a handheld. One significant issue is the size of the image that you project behind you. Being able to show it that big is quite handy. Yeah. But it doesn't, in operational terms, it doesn't make any difference. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 88.8 degrees. Okay, I think you got the idea in full now, so I'm not going to repeat it. But do check your neighbour, by the way. They're probably thinking they can get away without writing on what basis by now. And don't let them, okay? You just hassle them and make sure they write the basis. So we did it in two different ways. Firstly, we did it in this way with the teacher doing it with the students engaging in exactly the way you've done. And this worksheet is part of the Bolin material, so I've just printed that directly from the teacher's guide on that. But the other way we did it was we had two microwaves, one at each end of the room, six laptops, six temperature probes, and students working in groups of five. Now, in operational terms, basically the pizza takes 2 minutes to heat up. So it meant that there was a queue which lasted at most 7 or 8 minutes for students actually to get their turn to heat up their pizza. But curiously, they seemed to be rather compelled and bewitched by watching pizzas heat in microwaves. So that wasn't much of a problem. And I just think it's cute that an activity that we could reasonably do in a Year 8 classroom, that's 12-year-olds for people not familiar with Year 8, the term linear interpolation actually makes perfectly reasonable sense, i.e., halfway between those two. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 86.6. Do be careful when you fill that in. That was missing one. This is so classroom realistic. Oh, is it going to be? I've got to get it. Oh, please, please, please. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 85.6. Do you want one more? Now, don't forget, please, you must continue to be updating your column which says on what basis you made that prediction. That's very, very important.